How to connect a thermostat terneo to the mobile app in iOS. Hi everyone, in this video I will show how to connect the smart Wi-Fi thermostat terneo in the iOS application and show you how to properly configure it and save costs on underfloor heating. First, let's download the terneo application from the App Store and open it. Next up, you need to register or sign in with the help of an Apple ID, Google or Telegram. We tap the Add a Device blue button. Then you need to fill in the name and the password of your Wi-Fi network. Pay attention, the router always has two options, 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz of frequency. Be sure to choose the 2.4 option. To connect the thermostat to the application, you need to switch the thermostat in the AP mode, short for access point. The thermostat is in this mode by default for the first 10 minutes after you switch it on for the first time. It's indicated by the beeping blue signal as you see on the screen. If you didn't connect the thermostat in the first 10 minutes, you can switch to the access point by pressing each of the buttons once, from left to right. After that, press and hold the menu button before you can see letters APC, short for Access Point Controller. With the help of plus or minus buttons, set the value to AP. Done! The blue light beeps again. It means that the thermostat is in the access point mode. Let's get back to our terneo application, press Next. Then we choose our thermostat. If the following screen appears, you need to go to Wi-Fi settings, press the Wi-Fi, then go to Other networks and choose a thermostat. Enter the password, starting with letters DSE, followed up by first 6 digits from the Wi-Fi network title. After that, we wait before the thermostat is connected. An important note, do not close or minimize the app until the process is finished. Done! On the pop-up question, do you want to connect the thermostat to the account? Press Yes. On the question, do you want to change the name of the device? Press Yes. Then we type the name of a thermostat, for example, kitchen. Please note the importance of filling out the power value. It's important to add the values from precisely your heated floor. This way, the thermostat can correctly monitor your consumed electricity statistics. In case you don't use the default sensor that comes with the thermostat S6, you should choose the type of a sensor in the drop-down menu. Done! Our thermostat is now in the app. The next logical step would be to add the electricity billing costs. This way, from the very start, you will be able to see the expenditure statistics on the underfloor heating, both in kilowatt hours and in your currency. That in turn helps to optimize the work in a way to save the electricity bill. The main idea of the smart thermostat is for it to be used mainly when you are at home and use it in a lower temperature or leave it off when you are not at home. Go to the schedule mode in order to change your daily heating schedule. Here, you can turn the Geofencing feature on. This way, the thermostat will be switched off automatically when no one is at home. These settings will help your underfloor heating to save on electricity with minimal interference. Let's get back to the main menu. In case you have a couple thermostats, say 4 or 5, and you want to fit them in one screen, you can change the size by using the widget. Under the thermostat name, you can see the current state of your Wi-Fi network. The pointed down arrow means that you need to update the thermostat firmware. On the left side, you can see the current temperature, while on the right side, the comfortable temperature is shown. The orange icon on the left indicates that the thermostat is working on heating the floor. You can change the comfortable temperature you want to have using a yellow scroll bar below. To change the temperature mode tab on the blue button, here you'll have several modes. Hand, maintaining the same temperature. Luggage, maintaining a minimal temperature up until you return home. And the switch off mode. Clock, you can change settings if your weekly schedule. Here you set your weekly schedule. You can add up to 16 temperature sections on each of the day. Pay attention. If you want to change the temperature using a yellow scroll ball, the mode will automatically be changed to a temporary mode. It means that the new temperature will only last until the end of the temperature section in the schedule. It will then default to the schedule mode. It's a good feature to use in case you go to work earlier or come back later than usual. To access additional settings, tap the three dots located on the right side from the thermostat name. Here you can add new users or switch the geofencing on. If we decide to connect another thermostat to the application, for example bathroom thermostat, you can group both of them together. You can also give the group a different name, we'll rename it to home. This way, you can change settings on both of them at the same time. For example, you'll be able to change a schedule geofencing and switch the thermostats on and off simultaneously, in one tap. For that, access the three-dotted menu left from the group name. These are the additional settings for your group. I hope this video was useful for you and helped you to connect the smart Wi-Fi thermostat terneo. If there are any questions left, leave them in the comments under the video. Our engineers are always ready to answer. Thank you for your attention.